Ayo. I know. Hey, it's Free Comic Book Day, and I'm over here with Dave Nerdfingers and Canteen, and we got our supplies. So we're gonna need boxes for this. We got a bunch of Free Comic Book Day stuff, plus we bought some stuff. Hey, look at that. Cool, coolness. So
That's
Dave's got his stuff, and
coolness.
Made a score.
Woo!
First print of Batman Elmer Fudd. So we're gonna move on to the next place and see what happens, but first we gotta make a pee-pee, huh?
Poop
All
break.
right.
Poop
poo-poo break.
Poop break.
All right. We're gonna Nerdcore peace out for momentarily, and we'll see you in about 3 seconds, I guess. But it won't really be
Edit.
3 seconds.
Edit. 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 Welcome to this Free Comic Book Day / Cinco de Mayo edition of Nerdcore. Hit the music.
Half-price books.
Yeah.
With their crazy sale, and they gave away one free comic, which wasn't Free Comic Book Day cons, just old school dollar books. And then we found some really good key issues in there for $1 or $2 a piece, man. Like stuff I can't even believe that's in there. Like
the new school. They're all new, brand new books.
Stanley stuff.
Brand new. Yeah. This. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, books are only like 2 months old. Mm-hmm. For $1. All right. Let's roll on to the next one. Okay. Round three. Ding,
Edit.
Ding.
Edit. Edit. Edit.
Oh, yeah.
So we got the 50 cent haul.
These are all mine.
There's some gold in there, bro. Gold in there. Some fucked up shit, too. And then, look. You got some.
I got some in there.
You didn't get too crazy, huh? Where's yours,
Todd? Over in the car.
Mr. Lizzie.
Over in the car. Hey, man, I got a compliment on his shirt today.
Did you really?
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
Should I call you Tim or Mr. Lizzie?
Oh, yeah, I don't think you're going to get away with Tim.
So anyways, yeah, we'll be doing the dollar bin haul here soon, or 50 cent bin here all here soon.
Edit. 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 Edit.
That's a little.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Are we on? I find your lack of conversation disturbing.
Okay, so we're going to show our
free
comic book haul.
Oh, okay. Who's
good? For 2019.
Aren't you going to tell them what day? There you go.
The 4th. Ah! Be with you. And also with you.
Who's going first?
All right, you went to the flea market. You're already spoiling what you got.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. Save the suspense for last on your big one, but I guess never mind.
Do you want me to go?
Go. Let's see what you went. You went to the flea market before Free Comic Book Day.
All right, Archie Madhouse. Those are fun. This one, I don't know why this isn't big. Aren't they yummy, Archie? Yeah, Jug, and these cones ain't bad either. Look, there you go. That's one of those double entendres.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Some Archie's pal, Jughead.
It makes me heavy breathe.
Dude, what? And just like you get with Dave, unexpected.
A tale of the army.
Witching hour.
Expected.
There you go. How's that one? Marvel Super Special Kung Fu Pow Chicken.
The first appearance.
The first one?
Of Shang.
The first what?
Chi.
Alright, now you...
The master of Kung Fu.
Now, you know how you stop over your local drug dealer's place? He's always playing music that's way cooler and more obscure than you are. We found some of these yesterday. Some weird tales. This is the literary equivalent of your cool drug dealer. So these were flea market. Darth, you're up.
Did you find a good price on those?
Yeah. You're Darth Vader, you should know that. I mean...
Okay, so let's check out the free comic book day haul. You guys tell me if you didn't get one of these or not. But we got one of the Catwoman Under the Moon DC tail things. Here, we'll throw them that way. You get one of these?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. That seems like it's going to be a good one. Whoa!
Echo. Then, what is going
on? Casper Spooksville. Can't pass up a good Casper comic. Now, guys, we didn't have time to go through these and rebag and board. I'm waiting for boards to come in. I had to order halfbacks online.
Oogie and the Cockroaches?
Augie and the Cockroaches.
Very good.
All right. How about a Grumble and the Goon? Did you guys get one of those?
I don't think I did get one of those.
Dude, that's cool. That's a goon, dude.
I must have not just caught it.
And the Grumble thing seems kind of popular these days. I know they had a secret variant not too long ago. So.
I got
a Lady Mechanica.
No, I did not get that one.
Got one of those.
These are always cool. I like the artwork on these, man. The covers are always really cool.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure I got 3 years worth of those.
Punchline.
I didn't get one of those.
No, I didn't get that either.
Gonna need one of those. I think that was a key for some reason. I'm not sure. It may be a key or may not. Let's see here. How about a Midnight Sky? That looks spooky. Yeah,
I did get that.
Okay. That was a good one. Mm-hmm. I don't think we didn't get all 51 that were available. No. But Animosity. It's got a kitty on it.
I got one of those because of the kitty.
Almost looks like a Scooby-Doo kind of a thing, huh?
Mm-hmm.
No,
that second place we went, it seemed like, you know, obviously, we went to four different places, and they had limits on what you could take, obviously, you know, some would only allow six or eight or whatever, but that second place, the big place we went, seemed like they were completely unprepared for it, man. They ran out first thing. Mm-hmm. We got there early, and they were already wiped.
I did not get that one.
Ignition?
Uh-uh, I didn't get that one.
I think this is a first appearance or key or whatever, too.
Yeah, I was going to say the smaller shops seem to be more prepared.
Yeah.
Maybe they just didn't get as much foot traffic. I don't know.
I don't know. They all seemed really busy, man.
Yeah, they were.
The tick, there's always a free comic book day tick one, and this one's got him on a rocket chopper thing, so that's kind of cool.
I did get that one.
Every year they have a free tick. That's awesome. Now, this is the one everybody was anticipating, the Spider-Man one with Carnage. So this is like the precursor. It's going to be a standalone story for that Call to Carnage that's going on. And the coming and all, and that big war or whatever it's going to happen. I'm sure you guys all got one of those.
Yeah.
And I can finally learn how to collect comics. I got a guide here on how to collect comics.
Didn't get that.
38 years, I could have just got a comic. The Avengers, I don't know if there's anything exciting going on with this, if this is a key or anything. I want to say there's something about... Oh, it's supposedly a preview of Savage Avengers, but it came out Saturday after Savage Avengers was released, so I don't know. did you guys get a Stranger Things?
Yes.
I think I did.
Cool. And Black Hammer. Is Black Hammer, I guess it's like a flip book maybe. I don't know. Then, Deadly Class.
Yeah, I got one of those.
Okay. And, oh, the Turtles. Definitely needed a Turtles.
Yeah.
Cool artwork on that cover too. It seems like they're not being cheap with the Free Comic Books Day stuff. Like they're really... putting out quality artwork and stuff. Interceptors, you guys got one, bright pink covers.
Mm-hmm.
Donnie Cates, the guy who currently writes, well, I should say, up to this month, writes Venom, and he's real popular with the Thanos series. The Year of the Villain quarter book.
I don't think I got one of those.
You probably need one of those. Dude, the 1 in 500 variant is awesome. Actually, I just talked to Davey Nerdfingers this morning. He said that they had one at the one place for $30. I didn't even see it or I would have bought it, dude. Because the other places were 50, and Al said he sold his for 100.
Wow.
Yeah.
The new Vampirella series.
Yeah, of course I got that one.
Of course you got that one. So that's a key. Oh, dude, then the beautiful Matina Spawn.
Yes.
That's a reprint of number one.
Definitely got that one.
Yeah, that's cool. This book is the hot book, I guess. I saw they had them listed online for $15 already. Mm-hmm. The Dark Age. I don't know if it's a first appearance or not or what, but for some reason, maybe there's a little
print. I did get one of those.
Dude, and then these, we were looking through the old books, and this is, I don't know if it's a preview or not, it might be the first appearance of the Maul. The Maul, that number one is got optioned, and it's actually worth money right now. Mm-hmm. And then I found an old one from last year, Grim Fairy Tales 2, that I didn't have. And another different guide to collecting comics with She on the cover. And is that, yeah, now that's it.
Is that
everything? Does that look like everything you guys got?
Yeah, pretty much.
Cool. So yeah, it's free comic book day, guys. You guys need to roll out. Like I said, we hit 4 stores, so that's why we got so many. But I mean, some of them don't have a limit and some of them do. I mean, it just depends. You might be able to go to one shop and just get them all. I don't know. But it's definitely worth going. They usually have sales and giveaways and whatever else to coincide. Some of them have cookouts, you know. It's a celebration.
It was.
All right.
Even without them.
So Janine, you want to start with the where we went first?
Okay. I only got 2 books there, I think. I picked up a True Believers Star Wars because it was Star Wars Day.
Ooh, is the last issue? The last issue of the series? Is that what it is?
It is.
Yep, that's the final issue.
Last issue, yeah. So, but you know how I am with the True Believers.
Yes, I do.
I was waiting for Ryan Moore.
Rabbit.
Yes. Dead
Number
rabbit.
One.
So, I got those 2 at the first place.
Yeah, he put them back out on the shelf because I guess they're not hot anymore.
Really?
Yeah, I went to buy one and he had it jacked up to like $30 or whatever. And he's like, oh, I have these on my eBay prices still. Oopsie. And he had to adjust it to cover price.
Yeah. So, why not?
But yeah, why not, man? Cool, equal comic. Had a stack like this.
Uh-huh. Was that before I caught up with you?
Yeah.
Okay. I got you.
All right, what else you got? That was it?
That was it from that place. Oh, okay. Yeah. I only got 2.
We'll go this way since you didn't go to the first place with us. I got, let's see here. The first place, I didn't get a lot of stuff, but I did get this sweet cover price, War of the Realms variant.
The
side of the van. Dude, look how badass that is. Like, I already have a War of the Realms number one. I have that J. Scott Campbell-ish version, thankfully. But this, I've never seen a comic with that kind of artwork. You know what I mean? It's just badass, man.
That is 1970s style. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
They should just do a whole month where it's sides of
just
vans.
Just like that, yeah.
That would be really cool.
Right? They do all these themed covers.
Mm-hmm.
I also got a Dead Rabbit number one. For cover price. Man, you guys, I'm telling you guys pay these jacked up prices for hot books, man. Just stop, dude. I got this for cover price.
Yeah. Flavor of the month.
Yep. Yeah. And then that was it. I you know what? I bought a box and that was it.
I did get a box there too.
This is the place that I went and I was going to buy a giant size X-Men number one he had there, but the cover was all like it was split. It was almost detached, and then plus he jacked the price up another $100, and I was like, I'm not doing that, because he wanted $500, and when I was there 2 weeks ago, he wanted $400, and I'm like, I was ready for the $400, not the $500.
And knowing that the cover was torn like that,
Right.
Yeah, that seems a bit much.
Yeah.
For sure.
So, this one's mine. Okay, so go ahead, Todd. What did you get at the first place you went?
Well, this is another... place at the flea market. I can check buying comic books off a guy wearing a sombrero off of my list. Because that's what he
was
wearing.
Hey, that's the theme. Cinco de Mayo.
I guess he was a day early, but there you are. I don't know what this was. I bought this because it said Batman Strikes and...
Introducing
Batgirl. And I just didn't know, so I bought it.
I know what it is.
I figured you would.
It is a comic book that is coincided with an animated series.
Yeah.
I don't even know. And then somebody just gave me this NBC Comics. It looked pretty cool. I don't know what that is.
Oh, so it's like a Saturday morning by Harvey. That's cool, dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's in really nice condition for that's probably early 80s.
don't know, Mega Man. I never heard of the Night Force, so I've grabbed that.
I see those in the bargain bins a lot, dude. And I always think about buying them, but I don't.
New Teen Titans. There's a lot of stuff goes on in that, so for 50 cents a piece, I was taking it.
Oh, this out of the 50 cent bin?
No, this was at the flea market. Oh, yeah. I just got a pile, and the guy's like, give me 10 bucks.
Oh, wow.
Cool.
That cover, for some reason, I know you brought that up before. Maybe it was Wonder Woman doing the same thing, and you were like, seems to be like a theme. Silver Surfer. This was a very odd-looking...
Thunderstrike.
Yeah, that was a very odd-looking Thor. This was actually horrible. I would have quit the band if I was in Metallica and they drew this comic book. That's a bad artwork. I don't know.
They'll never stop. They'll never quit because they're Metallica.
Yeah. Captain America. Woo! What are you doing there, Spy Dog? You're getting excited.
You like that one.
Silver Surfer. This was, it's about a $10 issue. It's a first appreance of a team. I can't remember what team. I don't know why.
Starforce.
Is that what it was? Yeah. I don't know why on God's Green Earth somebody or Green Hulk gave him a big gun, but he's got one. That's the last thing he needs. A West Coast Avengers. Another Teen Titans. This is a Avengers. I don't know what that is. And one more Avengers. So these were all 50 cents, so it was about 10 bucks for all of these. Good?
Looks good.
There we are. So that was a fun day at the flea market.
Okay.
And then...
So then you met... Is that when you met up with us then at the second place?
That was the second place. The flea market was first, and then I met you guys at the second.
Let's roll with the second place stuff, Janine.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I only got two there. I was across the street from...
Oh, that's right. You didn't meet up with us yet, Todd. We stopped at Half Price Books.
We stopped at one more place. We actually didn't know that they... We just went over there just to look through to see if they got any new books. And they were actually doing Free Comic Book Day.
Yeah, they did it a little different.
They actually just, you know, they had boxes of dollar comics, and as you came in, they just told you that, you know, pick one out of the box, and that, you know, that would be a free one for you. And I only got two of them there. I got Venom, Carnage.
Now, they put stickers on the covers of some of these, so we're going to have some surgery.
Some of them have stickers. And then I got the new X-Men 115, which is Megasonic, Teenage
Mutant
Warhead.
Yeah.
Because I always forget like something in there. But yeah.
Is it? Did they name the character after the song?
Find
or the song
your
after
lack
the character?
Of memory disturbing.
You've been freaking the dog out. Go ahead, you're up.
So this is the Half Price Books haul. Oh wait, that one isn't one of them. Neither is that. Hold on. Let's see what we got here. I got them screwed up. I got them back.
I was going to say, use the first.
Okay.
Come on, Garth.
So I bought this because I thought it was number two, because it has a big number two on there. But here it's like number issue 40 or something. It's a Sandman issue 40. I thought it was the second appearance of Sandman maybe, so I just grabbed it. I could have checked my app. I don't know. I suck. But one of the books I've been looking for, I just found out about this week, is She and Sideblade. It's the first appearance of Witchblade. And I was wondering if I was going to see it in a dollar bin. And we went to Half Price Books, and they had that there for $2. I was like, bang.
Yeah.
And then I dug a little more, and I found the other cover. Look, if you look,
They're switched.
Yeah, they're switched out. So I grabbed that. And I showed Janine. I was like, keep an eye out for them in a dollar bin, because I can't believe I just found that. And that was one of the things I was looking for today. Then we found this Midnight Sun's ash can.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
So, one of the things with Ghost Rider and everything going on, Midnight Sun's going to be a big thing with the supernatural. Mm-hmm. So I figured the preview would be kind of cool to have. And this is the a cover to what Janine got, the first appearance of the Negasonic Teenage Warhead. She got the variant. And then I found the first appearance of Criminal Macabre, Kyle MacDonald.
Cool.
Most of these were, they were all $1 or $2. Hulk number 2, I think this might be the first full appearance of Red Hulk, I'm not sure. I know there's something with number 2, I just grabbed it, but it's a cool cover. Secret Invasion number 1, I figured there's a pretty good chance that'll be happening in MCU, so having the first issue, it's in mint condition, is probably pretty nice.
Mm-hmm.
I've been looking for this, dude, and this is ASM 797, the A cover, I have the B cover. Glad to find it for $1 or $2 or whatever. Janine found this. This is a really cool homage to ASM 129, The Punisher, Dark Reign. This, I'm not sure. This might have something to do with the Cosmic Carnage. I'm not sure, but I grabbed it. I know I don't have it, and it's just a badass cover to begin with. I'm not sure. ASM 410. So, but regardless, it's badass. So, then I found a Venom 162 that I did not have, as well as a Batman Beyond first appearance of the old Joker, the Joker Beyond, or whatever the hell you did call him. The variant, the Quesada variant, Virgin variant of New Avengers number 1. I never saw that before. And then I found some Swamp Things that I was missing for the volume, I think it's volume 6. And I think these might be Kelly Jones covers. Back when he still drew like Kelly Jones. So I grabbed them.
That's a cool cover.
Yeah. This is Zatanna.
Mm-hmm.
And then that was it for that, for half price books. That was more than enough, honestly. I wasn't expecting to spend money at half price books, to be honest. We went there, it was so random because we just had time to kill, man.
You never do until you go in there and you're like, wow.
Right.
Yeah. Which way are we going here?
It's your turn now.
Is it? I picked up a 2016 Free Comic Book Day that I found because it has Mercy Sparks Year One on it, and also has Badger versus Vladimir Putin. So I had to take it.
What was it, Badger versus Vladimir Putin?
There you are.
Wow. Okay.
Right before your Darth Vader-y eyes.
Somebody's got to fight him, I guess.
Stephen Strange becomes the Herald of Galactus. This is just cool.
Oh, you found a Captain America.
Yep.
How much?
Well, it said $5.50, but I didn't pay that.
25% off.
Yeah, so it was less than cover price.
I can't believe you got that. I would have never thought that would be in there.
Yeah, you had to know where to look. This was a freebie from a couple years ago. And so was Captain Canuck. So, there you are. That was at the third place I went to.
But that was the fourth place that we went to.
Yes. Yes. That was after our paths diverged.
So let's see what you got the third.
Okay. The third. This was the first time we went in. Because we went in and we got...
We just bought stuff off the shelf. And then got our Free Comic Book Day stuff. And then came back in for the 50-cent sale.
Mm-hmm. So I got... Jughead the Hunger versus Vampironica, which I'm going to try to, I think I'm going to get that one signed.
Robert will be there. That's the variant.
And actually, Dave found, he found both of these.
Mm-hmm.
The Howling Commandos of S.H.I.E.L.D., number one, the variant.
That's allegedly the 1 in 10 variant. And that's first appearance of Glyph, who they just, license for MCU.
Cool.
And you also, I can't believe how many of these that he has found. But
he found one for me.
Mockingbird number 1, the variant.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So that's what I got the first time we went in.
I used the Forge.
Yeah, those were some good finds.
Maybe we should change the name to Nerd Force.
Nerd Force.
It's not like
welcome to Nerd Force.
It's not like it's printed on t-shirts yet, so.
All right. So the first time I went in, I found this Meet the Skrulls number 4. And then I found a Batman Who Laughs number 1 first appearance of Grim Knight, but this is the second printing. I didn't even know they did that. Nerdfingers. Baby Nerdfingers found that.
Yeah.
And then I found a 1 in 10 Howling Commando. Yeah, George gave us the heads up on that. And then these are Hawkeye number 1's variants. Dude, we got all these variants for $3 a piece, and they're all hot.
Mm-hmm.
And then that was it for that, except for I grabbed a, they had this on the wall for $40, and this thing's hot, man, and they didn't, must not have known. And I don't know if I can, because it doesn't matter, they stamp some of the books too. But She-Hulk number 1, probably around an 8, I would say, if I had to guess. And shit, man, for $40.
Yeah.
So I'll get two of them. Mm-hmm. Well, my plan is to get this one CGC'd as well. Keep whichever one's a higher grade, and by that time they should both be really hot. Mm-hmm. And I'll use it to trade in to get something else I want.
Sounds like a plan. So that was what round was that for you guys?
That was the first time we went in. Okay. And then when we came back. Do you have more stuff?
This is my last stop, and some of it is free comic book day, so I can just throw it off to the side as we go. But this is the last store that I went to. Ready?
Sure.
All right. I picked this up because it was 50s pre-code horror. Good stuff. Dirt cheap X-Men for $1. Can't go wrong with that. I don't know why I bought this Carnage.
That's awesome.
Is it for $2?
Was that yeah, I do.
All right. This issue is absolutely insane because they do something with the DC Marvel Universe. I think Phoenix is in there far off in the distance, totally buck naked. It's a really weird issue.
They have they have DC characters show up in that issue,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, and they were, like, making fun of them and stuff. Mm-hmm. I was doing a little bit of reading. This is a key. I don't remember why.
It's a famous cover.
Dave really likes this cover, so I grabbed it.
Oh, yeah.
They had a copy of this for $2.50.
First appearance of Bishop. That's what you need to be looking for. That's the go with your other one.
So there you go. First appearance for $3.
Wow, what's that?
Spawn number 2.
That is cool, dude.
Mm-hmm. It was $3.
I can't believe it.
That's why I grabbed it.
Keep it in that bag, dude.
Yeah. Domino. Just because that was a new issue and I got it. They had an Avengers. I don't know which one this is.
It's first appearance of Voyager.
It's also, is it the green blobs or the teeth or whatever? You know what I mean?
I don't even know.
It's it. The Immortal Hulk starts showing up slowly but surely in these. This was a key issue. Something of that. Avengers 684 for cover price.
Where'd you find those?
And Avengers 684 for cover price.
Is that one of the places we went?
Nope.
No shit. It's
the little tiny rinky dink place sells the models.
Oh.
I stopped on my way home and popped in there, and
nice.
That's where I found all that stuff. So
cool. That's awesome.
So that's
you
know, that,
if we're going to that con next week, if I was you, I'd take one of those, or maybe both of them, and trade them.
I got three of them. Yeah.
Take them and trade them and get something really good.
Yeah, but so they had some good Avengers in there, and as usual, I blamed both copies on you. I said, well, my buddy's looking for this too. Because as soon as they see you buying 2 issues, they're like, something's up. So I'm like, oh, yeah. So,
cool.
But $4. So you know what, folks? You got to get off of the benches and into the trenches, because that's how you do it. So.
All right, what'd you find? This is the 50-cent haul now. This is everything that was $1 was 50 cents.
Yeah, 50 cents.
So we just dug through that sea of dollar books again and got everything for 50 cents.
Okay, New Avengers 30.
30? Is that
30?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that some kind of odd variant, or was that the
cover? No, that's they just did that as the True Believers. That's a...
Really?
Yeah, I think what it is Ronan joins the Avengers team, I think is what it is. Really nice copies of these.
Yeah. Uncanny X-Men 208. And 209. I got... Deadpool, Too Soon, Punisher.
Is he knifing Howard the Duck?
He's using him as an arrow.
Oh,
that's the bow coming out of the top of his head. I see.
Yeah, he's using the duck as an arrow. There's the Punisher. I just
that reminds me of that Hot Shots Part didn't they do that there?
But that's number 4. I thought that, I don't know, I just thought it was a cool cover. And then I also found...
She Sideblade, first appearance of Witchblade.
I found that one and also this copy.
Awesome.
So that was Spider-Man 2099 variant, which was really cute. Guardians of the Galaxy number 3 Fred variant. The dog is smelling him because, you know, he's a tree.
Lockjaw.
This one, I don't know. I just thought this was cool.
Who signed it?
It's limited to 500 copies. I don't know.
I don't know.
There's a sig on it.
Yeah, that's what we were. That's why she bought it.
But it says it's Tales of Honor. It's the Calgary Expo, limited to 500, and it's signed by someone. There's nothing in there to say who it was.
We'll have to research that.
I wonder if it's in the back of behind the comic book.
Maybe. We'll have to take a look.
Probably
at that.
Not.
Probably not. That's
probably why they threw it in there, because
I thought it was cool, so I don't know. For number one, variant.
That looks like an Arthur Slaynam.
That looks like a Frazetta shot, too, like a pose.
I'm going to take these off because I don't want them to. Avengers 317 and 316.
Those are the, that Spider-Man storyline you're trying to...
Yeah, I'm trying to get them. Fallen Angels number 2. Which we all know are
first appearance of Bill the Lobster.
First appearance, Bill the Lobster. Hawkeye, number one.
Hawkeye.
Guardians of the Galaxy 37. I did not have that one. And 28. 36.
Todd found that one.
Uh huh. And then Todd found this wizard with Spawn on the cover, so I just had to get that one. So that was it for the 50 cent books that I got. This one I got, the other one I got at the last place we stopped, but yeah. Okay. That was pretty cool. I couldn't pass that up with Spawn on the front.
Cool.
So that was,
give me a sandwich since we don't have the backing.
I don't wanna get some support on that.
That should work. Alright, so I found a New Mutants 45. Bought it just because it was in really nice condition, and it's that border I really like, and I need to get these. And then same with this Fantastic Four 296. This is a book I had when it first came out. I bought it off the shelf, and I don't know whatever happened to it. Silver Surfer number 1. This is volume one of the early, the 80s volume.
Yeah.
And I never had that, so that's a good one. Found a DCU Holiday Bash I don't have. Like, apparently that's a variant. Swamp Thing number 90. This is the first appearance of Swamp Thing's daughter. What's her name? I want to say it's like Fifi, or I can't even remember.
Fifi.
It's something goofy. Oh, Tefe.
Oh, that's way better.
Yeah, I never guessed that one.
Black Orchid number 1. I didn't know if this is the first appearance or not here. Apparently it's volume 2. But whatever. Todd found this. This is a holiday issue. It's an annual of Avengers. You can see they're all in a sleigh. Mm-hmm. And believe it or not, this was in the CLZ app. This Cosplayers Christmas. So that's one more for the Christmas collection. Alpha Flight 53. This is like the second or third Jim Lee work at Marvel. And a cool cover. Another Alpha Flight 33. First appearance of Deathstroke. This one's in pretty nice condition, man. Probably very fine plus. A Wolverine and the X-Men number 1 for my Wolverine collection. Because I don't have that. And... then I got a Gwenpool Holiday Special. Guys, there's so many variants of this. This is the 4th variant. So we grabbed that up. Damn, I got one. Another Hawkeye number 1. The dollar bin, which was 50 cents. I grabbed these Howling Commandos as Shield just because I grabbed it, had those number 1s. So there's 2, 3. Another Hawkeye number 1. That's the one that everybody's looking for right there, I think. I saw somebody else had one of those pulled out. So they must be all through there. Another Howling Commandos of S.H.I.E.L.D. A Hawkeye number 2. I think this is like the first appearance of somebody. I can't remember. Hawkeye number 2. All new Hawkeye number 2. I think they're both... I don't know if they're the same or not. X-Men. Got another copy of that X-Men Deadly Genesis with the giant-size X-Men homage. First appearance of Vulcan. Just because it's Justice League Dark, and I got a Justice League Dark collection, 50 cents, what the hell.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Then I started getting into these Swamp Things, and I got a bunch of really nice copies of Swamp Things. And I can tell you, with these Swamp Things, I can afford to be picky with these things, even at 50 cents, because they're everywhere, man.
Yeah.
But I got a couple of these Avengers, like 226. Guys, these look like they're right off the friggin' shelf, man. The gloss is there. There's no damage. They're just beautiful. Mm-hmm. I needed a second one of these Marvel Ages because it's a Christmas issue. So one for my collection, one for my Christmas issues. Then I got, dude, these Uncanny X-Men's I grabbed. 187, 185. They're all, I already have these, but I swear to God, these might be in nicer condition than the ones that I have. I couldn't believe how that these were in a 50 cent bin and as pristine. I mean, these are pretty much museum quality ones. And they're not even in bags and boards, which is mind blowing. Mm-hmm. Then I just grabbed this Quasar 26 because it was a cool Thanos cover. I'm sure you have that, Todd. You have all those Quasars, huh?
I have a good bit. I don't have them all. I don't know if I have that one, but I was working on that run.
There's another. This is one of my favorite early covers, dude. Look at that.
That's not the first time he's assaulted a kid on a cover. I mean, I'm serious, you know?
I think this might be the first appearance. This is Uncanny X-Men 184. It might be the first appearance of Forge, I think. Then this, just because it's a good opportunity for 50 cents to get a blank cover. I can eventually get artwork. Somebody draw me a hot Supergirl or something. Flash Gordon Christmas issue that Palmer... 303. I don't know. Dude, I've been looking for the Pressman variant of this, and I didn't realize I don't have the regular version. So I got one of those. Then the What the Xmas special. Is that What the number 10? I got this because I don't have this, but it's in pretty nice condition, and it's that Black Widow cover, man. That's badass. Daredevil 188. This Detective Comics, I'm not sure. This is 524. It's got a marker on there, but so somebody took that too. This could be it. I think this might be an early appearance of Killer Croc. I might be wrong, but I think so. Archie's Christmas Lovin'. I cannot believe the amount. This is the Archie Giant Size series. I cannot believe the amount of Christmas issues they have.
Oh yeah.
Here's another one that is sweet. Look at that, dude. Sweet Avengers. That's 231, dude. That's from the early 80s. Look how nice that is. Same with 228. The Trial of Yellow Jacket, because he's an asshole. Boom. Perfect condition. Then.
Nice.
I found, and it's stamped though, but it's from the, I just got some spittle on there. Third Eye Comics edition, but it's the Infinity. This is the first appearance of, I believe, Grell, the Darkseid's daughter. Mm-hmm. Janine found me. Finally, I got one of these. Bloodshot number 7, first appearance of Ninjak. Another X-Men 206. All in pristine condition.
Yeah, those are really nice.
Mm-hmm. Look at that, dude. Mm-hmm. Like, you just look at the gloss on this. And the same thing with these Secret Wars 2s, number 9. And then number 5 is the first appearance of Boom Boom from the X-Men, so that's probably a good spec. And number 4, I forget who, this is the first appearance as well, isn't it?
I can't believe that series is in those dollar bins. You know what
well,
I mean?
Well, Secret Wars 2 isn't really as held in high regard as Secret Wars 1, but still, those are good ones. All Hallows Eve for my holiday collection. Then Todd found this. This was a Harley Quinn bomb, DC Comics bombshell. It's just a cool cover, man, of Harley riding a bomb. Thor, God of Thunder, number 25. You know, the one guy who worked there said he was digging through the dollar bins the other day, and he found issues 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So issues 2 and 6 are the ones that are worth money, and he said they were in perfect condition.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. It's amazing what they just bring in and just throw in there and go, you know. Yep.
Grab this up because this is in pristine condition. It'd go with my Secret Wars, I guess. But this badass cover, painted cover of Secret Wars or Secret Invasion number 5. And then this is probably the nicest copy I own now. I have like 3 copies of this, but this is that iconic cover from the Marvel Zombies. It's Ultimate Fantastic Four number 30. And then again, I found, and I think Todd found one of these for me. It's that Tefe, that first appearance Tefe. And then some Swamp Things I was missing. And again, I only grabbed the best ones because I know in that bargain bin I'll find mint ones of everything, especially with the Swamp Thing series. Then I found one of those AIM toothpaste giveaways. This one has the Green Goblin on it. So it's got the Gobbler. And then I found half of this story. I've been wanting to get these, and especially for 50 cents I grabbed them. It's the Cap Wolf, where Captain America was the werewolf. It's Captain America 407.
Because it's only a matter of time.
406. You knew Wolverine had to show up in there. And this is the cover for all of them. Look at that.
Oh my God.
Yeah. And then this one's really unique, dude. I wanted to show you guys this. Now, I know we see these darker images in every bin, right? Yeah. And this one's in mint condition, which is part of the reason I bought it. But guys, a mint condition, especially Image comic books, you don't see them. They're usually direct sales. Mm-hmm. This one's a newsstand, dude, and it's a mint condition newsstand of darker Image. Mm-hmm. So if this thing ever hits, you know how people are. So this is when newsstands were going out, and to find these independent comics in a newsstand, and especially in mint condition, there was no way I was leaving it there. I know I got like 5 or 6 of these things, but so if you guys see like Spawns that are newsstand or anything, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's definitely something you want to consider, especially if they're in nice condition. Mm-hmm. So, is that it? I think that was it. We just went to that other Free Comic Book Day place and called it a day, didn't we?
Yeah, and I got one book. Oh, you got there.
One book?
I did. Okay. I had to pick up My Girl in the Bay, number 4.
Yay, purple cover. Woo. It's purpley. That's perplexing. Yeah.
Has anybody read any of that yet?
What's that?
Has anybody read any of that?
I have not. No. I read a bunch of comics over this week, though, because I had some time off, and I read a bunch. But
yeah, I mean, I didn't know if the story was good or not.
I'm sure it is. It looks like it's badass, dude.
I have not started reading that one yet.
That's J.M. DeMatteis, so he's usually really good, man. Mm-hmm. I did read War of the Realms 1 and 2, and I really enjoyed those. I read No Road Home, the final issue. I loved that series, and that final issue, I was just kind of like, I don't know. I wasn't digging the final issue.
I haven't, but I didn't read it.
Yeah, I didn't read all of them yet.
What else did I read? I know I read other stuff, but I can't think of what it was off the top of my head. But, yeah, so I'd recommend the War of the Realms as of for right now, and... God, I can't wait to get some of these bags. I got the bags from the special place, but I didn't get the boards.
I ran out of boards yesterday, so...
I actually bought bags and boards yesterday.
You're the only responsible one out of all of us.
Well, when I found out that we weren't going to that other place because they had a marathon going on, because it was downtown, there's no way we were going near that, I went online and ordered halfbacks. So I'm just waiting for them to come in from online, and hopefully I'll be here. That place I ordered from before, and they should be here by Tuesday, so then I'll be spending a week bagging and boarding most likely. So cool. I'll just keep these in my little short box.
Yeah, we gotta get caught up, because next weekend's a big weekend.
Yes, we got the convention coming up, and I got some ideas. I'm looking to trade. I'm probably going to trade in one of my Teen Titan 12 foil edition, the 9.8s, for something. I got a copy of Mortal Hulk, too, so I'm taking those two things with me to maybe trade on something. I wouldn't mind. Well, you guys know my list for like getting a Constantine and Hulk 180 and stuff like that, but I also would like to get a Nova number 1, and if I could find a high grade of this, I probably may just trade even Steven for a Teen Titans 12.
I don't know. This is going to be an expanded con. It's in a bigger place, so we'll hopefully it'll be some new blood in there, as well as our old standbys, which are a couple pretty dependable guys, and they hook us up.
Our friend George is setting up a table there too, so cool. So if you go to the bathroom, make sure you stop in and look at George's table, because he's right next to the bathroom, which is really, like Janine pointed out, that's a prime location. Everybody's going to have to poop.
Sooner or later, they got to go through there.
Like, everybody poops.
You might think it's, at first you might think it's a bad thing, but it might actually be a good thing, because how many people go to the bathroom when they're there all the time? You know, it might be a good thing. Might be the prime spot.
That has to be the first time Darth Vader ever said that.
Number... All right, we're gonna nerdcore out this special Free Comic Book Day /
flea market
Cinco de Mayo.
Oh yes.
What do you mean? Oh yes.
It's Cinco de Mayo.
It sure is.
I know, because I tried to go to a Mexican restaurant, which was a dumb idea.
But thanks for joining us, Todd Listerine.
And, good, Vizine. It's you.
Vizine, nerdcore out.
Nerdcore out.
Okay, since Todd is irresponsible, we found a bunch of new comics.
You knew that when we started.
We found a bunch of comics we forgot to show you guys. So go ahead, Todd. You start it off.
I just found this. This was just a weird one. It has 5 different comic books in it, and they all seem to be pretty We got Doctor Strange, guest starring Adam Warlock. Marvel Comics presents 91st Cable Ghost Rider team up. Punisher 57 with a special double cover.
Whoa.
Spider-Man 16 special sideways issue. And Uncanny X-Men 283, the first full appearance of Bishop. All cool. In this cool numbered plastic container. So I guess just leaving it in there might be a better idea.
Oh, yeah, definitely, yeah. Man. So, definitely.
But it's serial numbered 50,000. Wow. So,
well, remember, that's when comics were selling hundreds of thousands of copies.
Yeah.
So everybody's buying five of them because they're going to retire off it.
Well, yeah, I mean, but the Bishop alone was worth the $5.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh,
so,
yeah.
There you go.
I would have bought that, too, if I would have saw it, dude. Absolutely, I was wise.
That's pretty cool.
You know, show me the Spawn one, too.
This one?
Yeah, check this out. I never saw this either.
We did this already, no. Sort of semi.
Oh, did we?
I think, yeah.
Yeah, this is a... Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But it's cool.
I showed the Powell.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So, but yeah, it was at the same store. So, okay. Yeah.
So the only thing you didn't show was this thing?
Yeah, that was I had left it out on the table. So, but what did you leave out on the table?
Well, these are in the back of the box. It's just some Venom Space Knights. These are, I was missing that one. And I found it. Two more copies for 50 cents of that She-Sideblade. Guys, everybody's sleeping on his first appearance of Witchblade, man. If you see it in a dollar bin, grab it. Got another Christmas issue of Katie Keene.
I bought a Katie Keene too yesterday, but I didn't bring it. It wasn't that one.
And then I was looking for... I've been looking for this because I was missing this in my collection. My LCS must have forgot to put it in. And I talked to the big shop. They said they had to order number twos before they ordered number ones, and that's maybe part of the reason. There might be a low print run on these. I don't know. But Daredevil number two of the new series, man. Mm-hmm. So I finally got one of those. And then this was in the 50 cent bin, Lord Pumpkin. I think you might have found that.
I found that. It was just so neat. I was going to buy it, and I thought, but Dave will display it.
Definitely a Halloween comic,
yeah,
man.
So that's why I just kicked it to you.
And then next to last place we went was they had 25% on. Same place you found that 25% off. I finally got that Venom number one I've been waiting on. I don't know why I haven't bought it yet, but I did. I basically got for cover price. And then this is one of the ones I've been wanting to get too, and it's in like mint condition. It's Death of X number four. It's that X-Men 94 homage, but they're like dead. It's so that's just a badass cover, so I had to have it. So that's it. That's all we found.
Okay.
Cool.
Part two. Right.
So this time, for really reals.
Are we sure that's it?
For really reals. Nerdcore out!
What if I had the power to gather all of my favorite MCs with the illest comic book characters and they became arch enemies? Inconceivable, unbelievable, yet as wild as it seems. The Emperor and Stan Lee would coach the two opposing teams. Keep it clean. Move back.
Now, in the end, you finally understand the true power of the bargain bin.